Hassan, what more can you tell us about the situation of the convoy?
Well, the situation has really been ramped up a notch here. There is a major standoff now between the convoy and hundreds of Egyptian riot police. This is a result of a breakdown in communications, in negotiations, sorry. The issue of the volunteers being allowed into Gaza was resolved. All of the members of Viva Palestina are going to be allowed into Gaza, but the sticking point has been the 60 of the vehicles, 60 of the 200 vehicles, the Egyptian authorities have said will not be allowed into Gaza. They are mainly the American vehicles and the Jeep-type vehicles. Now, the organizers and the Egyptian authorities were negotiating on this matter, but according to the Viva Palestina organizers, the Egyptian authorities walked out of negotiations and left them with an empty table. As a result, they told the Viva Palestina members to begin a protest, an angry sort of demonstration to show their displeasure at this. That protest tried to make its way out of the Al Arish seaport compound and was met by hundreds of riot police who moved in and have now blocked in the Viva Palestina vehicles and the members, the people. In response, the Viva Palestina members have also blocked themselves in by putting two big trucks across the entrance of the compound to stop the police from getting in. So basically what we're seeing here is a major standoff between hundreds of riot police and hundreds of Viva Palestina members.
And what do the people of Egypt say to all this?
Well, that's a good question. The people of Egypt aren't really allowed to even meet the convoy. I think part of the reason why the convoy was forced to travel to Al Arish rather than Nuweiba is so that the convoy would not be traveling up the Sinai, and it would be going from Al Arish to Rafah, which is a very short 40-kilometer drive, so it would have much less exposure to the people. The last time on the first convoy, we saw the same thing with the Egyptian police lining the streets, preventing people from coming out of their homes to meet the convoy. But despite this, we did come across people cheering the convoy. This morning I saw school children cheering on members of the convoy. So there is some support amongst the population, a great deal of support, but the government is quite keen to reduce the visibility of that support.